Welcome, everybody. Thanks for coming out. My name's Rob Daly. I'm the mayor of Holladay, and proud to introduce Kage Hughart. He's a Kage Hughart and the Kage Hughart Project. Let's hear it. So Kage is a local guy. Won the Battle of the Bands last year, and this is kind of his and his band's reward. But so Kage and his band are going to play for about 30 minutes, then we'll take a little bit of a break and set up for Charley Jenkins. But anyway, thanks everybody for coming out and the Kage Hughart Project.
How's everybody doing out there tonight? That was weak. I want to hear it. Come on. How's everybody doing out there tonight on this fantastic summer evening? Woo! Got COVID going on. We're still here. We're not letting that control us, are we?
No, we're not.
All right. I just want to say thank you so much to everybody for coming out tonight. Give a really special thanks before we played. All the friends and family for coming out. My mom right here. My dear old daddy on the drums filling in for our normal drummer. All right. So if anything goes wrong, you guys can blame him, okay? And then I want to give a shout out to my lovely woman over here, my girlfriend Avery, who was just in a car accident just the other day. And she is here, made it here to support me. I love you so much, baby. Thank you.
Don't let me down. Don't let me down.
very much. An old Beatles tune for you. Don't Let Me Down. Yay. Next one we got for you is an old B.B. King tune. It goes a little something like this. How's it sounding out there? Is it all right? Fantastic. Okay. Way I was. Okay, here we go. One, two.
without you. Another sad song, another broken glass, and one more shattered future trying to forget the past.
Thank you. Okay. All right. Thank you very much. That was an original tune called Way I Was. This next one's called Half-Hearted.
Wait.
was half-hearted. Thank you very much. We'll be right back. All right, thank you very much. That was a little rendition of ZZ Top's Just Got Paid and Good Times, Bad Times by Led Zeppelin. All right, that was our one rocker for the night. All right, this one is called The Game. This is another original for you.
Still playing the game.
Thank you very much. Hey, guys, that's all the time we are allowed tonight, so thank you for listening.
And it starts with our Arts Council. Cheryl Gilliland, our Executive Director. Cheryl, where are you? Raise your hand. Where's Cheryl? Right here. So Cheryl and Kathy Murphy and all of our Arts Council people, if you'd raise your hands, thanks so much for not giving up on this. When we started talking about, for those that have come to our concerts behind City Hall, when the COVID thing happened, we were trying to figure out how to do this. And to make a real long story short, we came within a day of just giving up because it was just too hard to figure it out. And trying to find a venue and how we could pull it off. And this is the concept we came up with, but we couldn't find a venue that could accommodate it. And really, at the very last day before we pulled the plug, we called President McConkie and the Big Cottonwood Steak, and he said right out of the gate, you can use our parking lot. So if it wasn't for the Big Cottonwood Steak and President McConkie reaching out and saying you can use this, this concert wouldn't happen. I also want to thank Taylor Audio, Sean Taylor. I don't know if Sean's here, but the Taylor Audio crew for bringing the stage in. Thanks you guys for your help. And finally, our sponsors. We offer these concerts free to the public, but it's not free to bring these performers in. And for those that have come to our concerts, you'll notice that the talent level is exceptional. And this has been a really, really difficult time for all of our local artists. So not just tonight, but I hope as this continues, you'll all find ways to reach out and support arts in our community and local artists in our community. So to our sponsors, especially Holladay Bank and Trust and the Spratling family, they stepped up again big time this year, Rocky Mountain Power, and all of the other sponsors that have come together to help us pay for these concerts. We'd appreciate it. We couldn't do it without you. You know, and before I forget, how about Kage Hughart and his band over here? These guys, were they phenomenal? Fantastic. Cheryl, have I missed anybody?
I think I got it.
Okay, and finally, Excellence in the Community is a local organization that reaches out and engages local talent. And they're the ones that put all the work to coordinate bringing these bands in and different kinds of talent. And we're fortunate to have Jeff Whiteley, their director, here tonight, and he's going to introduce our band. And I would be remiss if I didn't thank all of you, too, because without your support, we wouldn't be able to pull this together. So everybody, be safe, enjoy the concert, and have fun. All right, Jeff.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Holladay Arts Council Uncommon Concerts, the last of the summer series. The mayor said pretty much all I need to say. Thank you so much for your support of music, live music, in this difficult time. We're very grateful to all those who make it possible. Excellence is very grateful to the Holladay Arts Council, to Cheryl, to Kathy, and to the mayor. We are so happy to be working together. And now tonight, we say goodbye to the summer. But we do it with a bang. This is Charley Jenkins and his band. Charley Jenkins is a country boy from rural Utah. When he sings about the country life, he's lived it. He's ridden the horses. He's rounded up the animals. He knows what he's talking about. But more important, he represents everything we're trying to do. Artistic excellence achieved by Utah musicians at the service of the community. Singing, playing, to make your lives richer, your children's lives better, to bring us together, even in the hardest and the most difficult of circumstances. Music is a healer and a measure of communion in tough times. Charley Jenkins, has won national awards. He has opened for national acts, among them Taylor Swift, and the list goes on and on. But what I find, and I think you're going to hear tonight and feel tonight, I have very rarely met a performer with as much personal charisma and warmth as Charley Jenkins. You're going to feel it tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage Charley Jenkins and the Charley Jenkins Band.
Seen me before? I hope so. I've been kicking around Hollywood a long time. I've made a lot of pictures, and some of them have been westerns. And now I'm proud to present my friend. He's a young fella and maybe new to some of you. And I predict he'll be a big star. So you might as well get used to him, like you've had to get used to me.
Of underachiever, and that I'm out here wasting time, chasing after this crazy heart of mine. Let me tell you why these wheels keep turning. I've got this fire that keeps on burning, taking me into the great unknown, where I hit the gas and away I go. Let's go, come on now. There might be some better way to make a living. What a beautiful night we have tonight. Thanks for hanging with us. What a great band, by the way. Those folks who take your dreams and make fun never had the guts to ever chase one. Their misery wants company. I think the Lord, he won't be me. Not me. Cause there might be some better way to make a living. But there ain't no better way to live. And I won't ever ask to be chasing every dream I have. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Come on, Rusty. Come on. Let's go. There might be some better way to make a living. But there ain't no better way. The way it is. All right. I'm going to ruin this song for a lot of you guys, because I'm going to twang it up. That's the only way I know how to do things, so here we go. I got a feeling that tonight's going to be a good night. That tonight's going to be a good night. That tonight's going to be a real good night. A feeling. Thank you for dancing. I was afraid we might lose some of y'all because that was such groovy stuff before. And then I'm just so glad you're still here. This is the first time we played this much country in a church parking lot before, by the way. Couple acres on the outskirts, little fenced in, piece of red dirt. And the banker had his pen out, said sign here. I kind of freaked out, all this talking about settling, had this old boy backpedaling, and I pushed back that contract, found my car keys, and I hit the gas. I don't know what I'm looking for, so I get some gold and look some more. Couple girls back, lost my head with a hazel-eyed brunette. Showed up, yeah, with all things, a little blue box with a gold ring. And I reached down in my pocket to find my nerve, but I lost it. Couldn't trust me with her around, so I put my heart back in lockdown. This is one of the most unique shows we've got to play this year, and well, it's one of the only shows we got to play this year. What a crazy year this has been, 2020. I know that we're gonna look back and be like, yeah, we made it through there, and we survived because that's what we do. And I just one thing I think that's become very obvious is the need of live music and the need of to be around one another, to see each other's faces and eyes and give each other hugs when we're cleared. And anyway, but you know, as a country band, we try to simplify things whenever we do anything.
because sometimes we do play concerts and some of our audience might be slightly intoxicated. And so we simplified it down to this. You take your left hand and your right hand, and then you just put them together with the kick drum right there, like this. If you get confused, it's just both of them. Just know that, okay? Yeah, there we go. Life on the farm was kinda laid back. Ain't much no country boy like me can't hack. Early to rise, early in the sack. Thank God I'm a country boy. Simple life never did me no harm. Raised me a family and working on the farm. Life's all filled with an easy country charm. Thank God I'm a country boy. Got me a fine wife, got me old fiddle. Sun's coming up, cake's on the grill. Life ain't nothing but a funny, funny riddle. Thank God I'm a country boy. When the work's all done and the sun's in low, pull out my fiddle and rising in my bow. Kids are asleep so we keep it kind of low. Thank God I'm a country boy. I play Sally Gooden every day if I could. With a wife and the Lord would take it very good. Fiddle when I can, work when I should. Thank God I'm a country boy. Got me a fine wife, got me old fiddle. Sun's coming up, cake's on the griddle. Life ain't nothing but a funny, funny riddle. Thank God I'm a country boy. Let's break it loose now. This is Grace Monson on that fiddle right there. This is Mr. Rusty Barnes on lead guitar. Got me a fine wife, got me old fiddle. Sun's coming up, cake's on the grill. Life ain't nothing but a funny, funny riddle. Now, did I tell you guys that I'm from Roosevelt, Utah? Wow, that got way more applause than it deserved. But what? Hang on, wait. Somebody say they're from Roosevelt? You love Roosevelt? Have you been to Roosevelt? What for? What's that? You don't know? You got lost one day and you found yourself in Roosevelt. Well, I probably owe you money if you stayed there for very long. But anyway, thank God I'm a country boy. I love Roosevelt too, by the way. So I know y'all, some of you might not be country music fans. And if you're not, 2020 is the perfect time for you to rethink your life, change your ways. We are going to play a bunch of songs that, you know, I grew up in that little town of mine that had an AM radio station. And my dad had convinced me that was the only radio station that worked. And so we listened to it day and night whenever we were doing stuff. And so I'm going to put a few of you to the test. If you can tell me who sings these songs, I'll give you a prize. I got a CD. Well, I'll give you a band member. Other than Grace, you can't have Grace because her husband would kill me. The rest of them, they'd give them away. So you can pick. But you got to tell me who sings these songs. If you don't know these songs, kids, I want you to go home and look them up and also tell your parents that they're failing you as raising you right, okay? See, a church parking lot's a good time to change your life. Here we go. Just a good old voice, never meaning no harm. Beat all you ever saw, been in trouble with the law since the day they were born. Straightening the curves, yeah. Flattening the hills. Anybody? Someday the mountain might get them, but the law never will. Yeah, they're making their way, the only way they know how. That's just a little bit more than the law will allow. You just gotta come tell me. Yeah, that's just a little bit more than the law will allow. That was Waylon Jennings. She said Merle Haggard, but guess what? First thing I remember knowing was that lonesome whistle blowing and a young one's dream of learning how to ride. You got the second one right? On a freight train leaving town, not knowing
tried, Mama tried, Mama tried to raise me better, but her pleading I denied. These only be to blame, cause Mama tried. These only be to blame, cause Mama tried.
Alright, that was Merle Haggard there. This next one. We lost this guy about 2 years ago. At one point, he masqueraded as a Beach Boy.
I've been walking these streets for so long, singing the same old song. I know every crack in these dirty sidewalks of Broadway.
Glen Campbell.
Where hustle's the name of the game, and good guys get washed away like the snow and the rain. There's been a load of compromise on the road to my horizon. Well, I'm gonna be where the lights are shining on me, like a rhinestone cowboy.
This guy not shortly after we lost Glen Campbell. Rusty says it's one of the coolest concerts he ever went to in his life. I believe him. He's been to a few.
I left Oklahoma driving in a Pontiac, just about to lose my mind. I was headed to Arizona, maybe on to California, where people all live so fine. Mama says I'm crazy, my baby called me lazy. I'm gonna show him all this time. Yeah, cause I ain't no fooling, I don't need no more schooling. I was born to just walk the line.
Anybody, I can't hear you.
Living on Tulsa time. I said living on Tulsa time. Yeah, you know I've been through it when I set my watch back to it. Living on Tulsa time.
One more time, here we go.
Living on Tulsa time. I said living on Tulsa time. Yeah, you know I've been through it when I send my watch back to it. Living on Tulsa time.
That is Don Williams right there. All right, if you don't get this one right, you're not an American. We just barely lost this guy. Sing along if you know it.
On a warm summer's evening, on a train bound for nowhere, met up with a gambler. We were both too tired to sleep, so we took turns staring out the window at the darkness till boredom overtook us and he began to speak. He said, son, I've made a life out of reading people's faces, knowing what the cards were by the way they held their eyes. So if you don't mind me saying, I can tell you're out of aces. For a taste of your whiskey, I'll give you some advice. You've got to know when to hold 'em, know when to fold 'em. Know when to walk away, know when to run. You never count your money when you're sitting at the table. There'll be time enough to count when the dealing's done. Yeah, every gambler knows the secret to surviving is knowing what to throw away and knowing what to keep. Cause every hand's a winner, every hand's a loser, and the best that you can hope for is to die in your sleep. You got to know when to hold 'em, know when to fold 'em, know when to walk away, know when to run. You never count your money When you're sitting at the table, there'll be time enough to count. When the dealing's done, you got to know when to hold 'em. Know when to fold 'em. Know when to walk away. Know when to run. You never count your money. When you're sitting at the table, there'll be time enough to count when the dealing's done. All right, one last one. We got to throw this one in there. You have to know this one. Seriously, here we go. I hear the train coming. It's rolling around the bend. I ain't seen the sunshine since I don't know when. I'm stuck in Folsom Prison, and time keeps dragging on. I'll give you a bowl. I'll get you one more. I'll get you one. But that train keeps moving on down to San Antonio. Yes, it does. Now, play me a country song, Mr. Rusty. Come on. Chance to share the stage with some pretty awesome acts, including Reba McEntire and Alan Jackson, and it goes on. But we ask everybody we get in front of, including right here in Holladay. This is technically Holladay, right? Because we got Murray Holladay. Y'all, yeah, Holladay. How many of y'all, you got to answer honestly, and I got to hear you because I can't see, these lights are blinding me. How many of y'all are Johnny Cash fans? All right, again, if you're not, this is the perfect opportunity, guys. Look, there's a church right there, right? If you're not a Johnny Cash fan, you need to repent and change your ways. If they freed me from this prison, that railroad train was mine. I think I'm moving on a little further down the line. Far from Folsom Prison, that's where I want to stay. And I let that lonesome whistle blow my blues away. Yes, I would. Yes, I let that lonesome whistle blow my blues away. Well, before we go on too far, we do have one Holladay native here. It's this guy right here on the bass. Roosevelt got more applause than that, Johnny. Just for 16 years, though, he wasn't with us. He was with another band. And finally, he saw the light and he joined our band. But he was busy for 16 years being a bass player and the band leader for a group. I'm going to sing one of their top songs. I'm going to try to. I can't really sing it. It's more like screech it. It's a little out of my range. But I want first person who tells me, you know, you get a free CD, which will make your day longer. Presley, I need two more CDs up here wherever she is. Yeah, here we go.
I'm all out of love. I'm so lost without you. I know you were right, believing for so long. I'm all out of love. What am I without you? I can't be too late to say that I was so. I'm all out of love. I'm so lost without you. I know you were right, believing for so long. I'm all out of love. What am I without you? I can't be too late to say that I was so wrong.
This is Johnny Lightfoot on bass. Yes, it was Air Supply for 16 years. Literally like 5 minutes from here is his house. And he invited us over, but we said, no, we'll hang out in the bus. That's bad. That's bad. Actually, we did go over. We did go over to his house. The bus is nicer. Yeah, whatever. We know that's not true. Whoever got that right, we'll get you a CD real quick. My daughter is going to grab one. But, you know, one of my other good friends grew up not far from here.
about, oh, it's going almost, man, I don't know how many years now, almost, maybe we hit the 10-year anniversary, but about 10 years ago, we started off, the song that we're going to play next started off at Primary Children's Hospital, and the reason why we were there is that my friend was waiting for a brand new heart. He was in his 30s. But he was at primaries because they knew of his condition from the minute he was born. And if any of you know who Paul Cardall is, you'll know that he's a fantastic piano player. And I'm just going to put this quick plug in. When you guys on a Sunday, like tomorrow morning, just want to add a calm feeling in your home, just ask whatever device it is or look up online Paul Cardall and just play his music, and it'll bring that spirit in. But we were up at primaries. He was hooked up to everything you could think of to keep him alive. And he, it was just him and I after a while. And I just said, Paul, I just want you to know, I pray every day, and I just believe that this is going to work out for you. And he stopped me and kind of surprised me by saying, thanks for praying, because right now I can't. And if you know him, that's pretty unusual. And he went on to explain that, you know, he knows that tragedy is going to happen, and when it does, you know, he's going to be the recipient of probably, you know, somebody's last gift of their life to him. But he was at the point where he needed it today. He needed it right now. And so he felt like that as he prayed and asked to be saved, he was literally asking that something happened to somebody else. And I said, I got an idea for a song. And when you get better, when this is all behind you, we're going to sit down, we're going to write this song. And thank the heavens that he did get better. And last year I looked on TV, and it was really sporadic because I had no idea. There was Paul playing Silent Night in front of our president and in front of our dignitaries, in front of the White House. And I thought, that's why our Heavenly Father put him here, so he could share that message. And this is a song that we came up with right here.
A young bride on her knees asking God, please don't let it rain, with the groom and family outside waiting on her special day. Please let the clouds blow by, oh, give us clear blue skies, she prays. Down the road a few miles out of town, a farmer's on his knees, his crops are dying in the field, won't last another week. Don't let the clouds blow by, let raindrops fill the skies, he prays. Sometimes all we see our slice of reality, the things are not as simple as they seem to be. There's times hard as we pray, heaven has another way, and even though there's nothing faith can do, sometimes that mountain doesn't move. Family hopes that the doctor's wrong when he says machines have kept her here, but she's already gone. Our daughter's way too young, don't let her days be done, they pray. Three floors up and just down the hall, a little one's shutting down. He's been the first name on that list, going on 6 months now. Please let this be the day a new heart's on its way, he prays. Sometimes all we see is our slice of reality, the things are not as simple as they seem to be. There's
this time's hard as we pray. Heaven has another way, and even though there's nothing faith can do, sometimes that mountain doesn't move. Hope one day I can see all the strokes in the masterpiece, then finally understand how they fit in the master plan. Sometimes all we see is our slice of reality. Things are not as simple as they seem to be. It's hard when we pray, heaven has another way, and even though there's nothing faith can do, he knows what's best for me and you. And that mountain doesn't move. Oh, well, thank you. Well, you, thank you. You know, as you can tell, we have somebody who's by far prettier than all of us put together on stage. And that's and I'm not talking about you, Johnny. You love to be called pretty, but this is Grace on my right, on your left up here on stage. And Grace, how long has it been since? Almost a year. September. Was it September?
October.
Goes so slowly. She got married last October. And we tried to talk her out of it, but she decided to do it anyway. And she married a musician, which is scary all the way around. But they're actually very, very happy together. But she graduated from BYU. And that was mixed reaction. There was people that were laughing, and then there was people that were like, woo.
And I still think that's the most applause it's ever gotten when you've been out.
Yes, yes. In Wyoming, it doesn't go over as well as it does here. But Grace is phenomenal on this fiddle, and she started playing when she was just little, and some people just don't get to see you do your thing. And this, I know this is kind of spontaneous, so I'm going to throw you under the bus. Not literally, but we're going to let you just cut loose a little bit. Yeah. While you're under there, I've got a lot of things to fix. But anyway, why don't you just take over and just do whatever you want to do, and the guys will follow you. Sound good? Okay. This is Grace. Grace used to be Dayton. Now it's just Monson. Time for Miss Grace here. No pun intended, but she's amazing.
going to try something, and I have no idea how this is going to work out or if it's going to even go over. But since we are a country band, how many concerts have you guys done here so far this year? This is the fourth. Have you had any country bands? Kind of? Okay. All right. Well, are we the kind of? Okay. All right. So we're going to officially mark something off your redneck bucket list. If you don't have a redneck bucket list, I highly recommend you get one. It's completely then your life bucket list. This is stuff that you shouldn't do. So what we're going to do, though, is we're gonna teach you a line dance. And you can, I don't know how you do with social distancing. If you feel comfortable, come up here and do it, or back there, or wherever. But I'm gonna teach it to you. And the reason why is I was on the show called Nashville Star back a long time ago. And I got no applause for that, by the way. Oh, you did, yes. Yeah, anyway, I had to do a line dance and sing the most hated country song of all time with the original singer, so I could not turn it down. So we are going to relive my moment. We're going to teach you the electric slide. I'll teach you all the steps, and then we're going to go into this song, okay? So you're going to officially be able to mark this off, and you won't have to do it again, or you just might get hooked, all right? So we need everyone to stand up if you want to. If you don't, then don't. How about that? That's really great, right? All right, so we're going to start by grapevining to our right. Even in Holladay, that's still that direction. So we're going to step behind, step, clap, and then go to our left. Step behind, step, clap. So that's half of it. Y'all are almost there. Okay, ready? Again, we go step behind, step, clap, step behind, step, clap. Now we're going to step back twice with our right foot, okay? So we go back together, and then we step forward with our left foot, and we stomp behind it. So we step forward, stomp, and then we step back, stomp. And that's basically it. Let's go to that point, and then there's one last thing. So again, we go to our right, we go step behind, step, clap, step behind, step, clap, back together, forward, stomp, back, stomp, turn, kick, and then you just do it all over again. You just go left. In the South, you'd say, just like NASCAR. All right, so I'll do it with you. I'm going to come down there because I can't see squat. Well, should I stay up here? Because you guys can't see me, so I have no idea what to do. We'll stay up here, and let's do this thing. Ready?
See y'all like our
giving up. You're almost there.
But don't tell my heart, my achy, breaky heart, I just don't think it understand. And if you tell my heart, my achy, breaky heart, it might blow up and kill this man.
Break it down, here we go.
But don't tell my heart, my achy, breaky heart, I just don't think it understand. And if you tell my heart, my achy, breaky heart, it might blow up and kill this man.
This, I think I owe you a CD right there, the Janis Joplin t-shirt lady. And then there was somebody else, right? So come up here, right, I'll give this to you. They haven't quite cleared me of the COVID thing, but here you go. Just kidding. I'm just teasing. You bet. They make great coasters, too, I'll just let you know. But running around here, I've got a little boy. He's been on a little scooter, and he's been probably obnoxious to a lot of people. His name's Cash. And then I got a 14-year-old, running around here, too. Her name's Presley. So I officially named my children after drug-addicted singers. I have no idea where they are. So this might be a little more down some of your vein right here, but, again, you can see who I really loved growing up. Higher, higher, it's burning through to my soul. Girl, 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 you got me set on fire. My brain is flaming, don't know which way to go. See your kisses take me higher, like a sweet song. Just a hunk of burning love. Just a hunk of burning love. We're caught in a trap, and I can't walk out because I love you too much, baby. Can't you see what you're doing to me? When you don't believe a word I'm saying, we can't go on together with suspicious minds. And we can't build our dreams on suspicious minds. That you cry. Let's don't let a good thing die. But you know I'd never lie to you. Oh, 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 oh. We're caught in a trap, and I can't walk. Baby, this is the best Elvis I can do right here.
Once men say, only fools.
Kevin said, number three, prettiest jailbird ever did see. Sure be light with your company. Come into the jailhouse, rock with me. Let's rock. Everybody, let's rock. Everybody in the whole cell block, we'll stand to the jailhouse rock. Come on, Rusty, now. Number three, prettiest jailbird I ever did see. Sure be lively the company. Come into the jailhouse, rock with me. Let's rock. Everybody, let's rock. Everybody in the whole cell block, we'll dance to the jailhouse rock. Oh, 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 dance to the jailhouse rock.
Well, thank you. Thank you. I appreciate that. They are, you know, I've learned a long time ago that the best thing I can do is bring the right people to the party. And, I mean, I feel like I've got great musicians and even better people in my band. For everybody up here on this, would you mind letting them know how awesome they are? Thank you. Except for, I just wanted to, I shouldn't even tell you this because this ruined it for me. That last song, Jailhouse Rock, Johnny has convinced me that he reminded me that as we sing that, that jails were not co-ed. And so he has a whole different take on ruining my vision of Elvis. Yes, the whole entire time. When number 47 said to number three, prettiest jailbird I ever did see. It's a little bit different, just saying. I'm not saying it's wrong, I'm just saying it's different. I hope I didn't ruin that for you. That's why I don't want to tell you.
Sorry.
So, like a lot of musicians, I wanted to chase my dream, and it's quite a challenge sometimes to balance out. Chasing your, I guess in life in general, chasing out after your dreams and then some of the risks, and especially when you start to get family members and kids, and there's quite a unique balance of trying to do that. And I think a lot of us can understand that just with our careers in general. But I had that opportunity, that small window right after high school when I served an LDS mission, and then I came home and I went off to Nashville. And I was really blessed to be hired and work down on Music Row. And if you've been to Nashville, it's changed a lot since I was there. But Nashville, Music Row is basically three streets. And in those three streets, they have everything from publishing companies where songs can be written on a guitar, on a piano, even in just their head. And then it can go into a studio down the block. And then it go from the studio to all the radio stations throughout the world in the next block. So it's pretty amazing. It's pretty powerful to know the influence it has. And the guy that hired me to work down there sat down one day. I asked him how he got started. And he said he was a journalist for a newspaper out of Chicago. And he sat down one day and he wrote a song. He said, "I wrote the saddest thing I could think of." I said, "Well, that's how most country songs start." And then he sent it off to his father, who had some connections in Nashville. And somehow it ended up on a tape. Some of you kids need to ask your parents what a tape is. And that tape ended up in a brand new artist out of Texas. And just so happened that this artist recorded it, released it as a single, and it was kind of the starting point for him. He said, I decided... whether to quit my writing job for the newspaper if this song would pay my bills. He said, at the time, with my wife and two kids, I needed $24,000
to pay for my family. He said the first check that came was for $24,000, and he took it as a sign. And this is the song that he wrote right here. He, by the way, moved to Nashville, and for 2 years he drove a car that didn't have headlights and didn't have reverse. So he left before it ever got dark and got there early enough to get a good parking spot. But this is the song right here. What a rotten day this turned out to be. I can't believe that she leaves so easily. She just got all her things, threw me into a pile, then loaded her car and said after a while, she's done this before, but this time she didn't cry. That's why I'm sitting on my front steps, staring down the road, wondering if she'll come back. This time I don't know, 'cause after she packed, when she looked back, there were no tears in her eyes. And that's got me worried, thinking maybe my baby's gotten good at goodbye. All the times before she'd break down and cry, she'd make her threats, but her heart wasn't set on goodbye. She just wanted me to hear what she had to say. Now I'm lost for words since she went away. She may not return, for this time she didn't cry. That's why I'm sitting on my front steps, staring down the road, wondering if she'll come back. This time I don't know, 'cause after she packed, when she looked back, there were no tears in her eyes. And that's got me worried, thinking maybe my baby's gotten good at goodbye. That's why I'm sitting on my front steps, staring down the road, wondering if she'll come back. This time I don't know, 'cause after she packed, when she looked back, there were no tears in her eyes. And that's got me worried, thinking maybe my baby's gotten good at goodbye. It's Mr. George Strait right there, by the way. I'm going to have Grace join me real quick. I've got one song that I played almost every time I've got the chance to perform. This is a song that I wrote for my dad. I got a call. I remember. In my mind, I know exactly where I was at and what I was doing when I got a call that my dad was diagnosed with cancer. And those are scary times. And we had a conversation where I said, I just want to pack up and come home, and he wouldn't let me. He said, I'll tell you what, if it gets to the point where I want you home, I'll let you know, because I want you to be out doing what you love to do. And thank goodness he did tell me one day when we had a conversation that it's time, I need you to come back home for a little bit. Best decision ever made. I got to come home with my dad before he passed away. And this is a song that I wrote for him with a good friend of mine in a group called Due West. And he wrote it for his father. And it's my way of making sure he's right here with me.
Dustin said he'd be a Dodger, but now he coaches Little League. He lost that scholarship in college when he blew out his knee. Still he tells the boys they're winners as long as they've had fun. Loads them up in his Suburban, buys pizza for everyone. It may not seem like he got far, 'cause kids can't buy his baseball car. But while the major leagues play on, he's a hero at home. Daddy's dreams were never bigger than the roads of our hometown. He planted grain and raised a family with a Bible and solid ground. The only thing he ever wanted, watch his crops and children grow. But an angel came and took him way before his time to go. It may not seem like he got far, died half a mile from where he was born. But the man he raised wants him to know that he's my hero at home. And to the world they go unknown, but they're heroes at home. Heroes at home. Thank God for heroes at home. Well, thank you guys. Thanks for hanging out with us tonight. Thank you for your arts council, for all the volunteers that were here to greet us and tell us where to park and what to do, and what crazy times. But to pull something off like this takes a lot of effort, especially during with all the restrictions that we have and the risks that people are taking. And I just want you to know from our perspective as musicians, it's life-saving to let us get up here, not necessarily financially is what I'm talking about, but emotionally, spiritually. This is how we connect to the world. And Jeff Whiteley, Excellence in the Community, all of the people that have put so much effort into this, we want to extend our heartfelt thank you for letting us come and perform for your city and for just for you guys, and let us feel your energy. We need this during this time, and we just want to say thank you, and I hope you express your thanks to them for all the efforts they put together to make this happen. Now, this next song, I consider it the theme song for Utah County. I'm not going to play I'm a Child of God, but it's this one right here, because Kevin Bacon showed up originally a few years ago. Down. hit the ceiling, or else I'll tear up this town.
Come on now.
I gotta cut loose, foot loose, kick off your Sunday shoes. Please, Louise, pull me off of my knees. Jack, get back. Come on before we crack and loose your blues. Everybody come for loose. You're playing so cool, obeying every rule. Dig way down in your heart, you're yearning and burning for somebody to tell you that life ain't passing you by. I'm here to tell you it will if you don't even try.
Come on now, you won't fly.
You gotta cut loose, foot loose, kick all your Sunday shoes. Ooh-wee, Marie, shake it for me. Oh, my Lord, come on, let's go and loose your blues. Everybody come for loose. Before we crack and loose your blues, everybody come full loose, kick off your Sunday shoes. Please, Louise, pull me off of my knees. Jack, get back, come on before we crack and loose your blues. Everybody cut, everybody cut. Everybody cut for loose.
All right, I honestly, these lights kind of blind me, so I don't know who's hanging with us still, but I will know after this, because I need audience participation. It's you. Yes, okay. All right, I need to hear you. You'll understand why. And if you don't know what to do, it's really quickly you can catch on. Where it began, I can't begin to knowing, but then I know it's growing strong. Was in the spring, and then spring became a summer. Who'd have believed it'd come along? Look at that. Hands, not touching hands, not reaching out, not touching me or touching you. Let's go, Holladay, here we go. Sweet Caroline, good times never seem so good. I've been inclined to believe they never would. Oh no, I look at the night, and it don't seem so lonely. We fill it up with only two. 200, maybe 300, think 400. And when I hurt,
hurt runs off my shoulders. How can I hurt when holding you?
Let's hear it now. Here we go.
Warm. Not touching warm. Or reaching out. Not touching me. Or touching you. Oh, sweet Caroline. Good times never seem so good. I've been inclined to believe they never would. Oh, no, I.
That is so cool. If you could be where I'm standing, seeing y'all out there. It's awesome to see you come alive. Let's hear you now. Here we go. One last time. Here we go.
Sweet Caroline. Good times never seem so good. I've been inclined.
Praise that he deserves, because he sits kind of hides behind here. He teaches as an instructor at 90th South at School of Rock. Mr. Van Christensen on drums. Let's do this thing. Sweet home, Holladay, Utah, where your sky's also blue. What a beautiful night, everybody. Sweet home, Holladay, Utah. Lord, I'm coming home to you. Now, I didn't introduce, officially have a part of this, that song, as far as a solo, because I wanted to save it for this right here. Miss Grace Dayton on fiddle, / Monson. Georgia, he was looking for a soul to steal. He's way behind as anybody, he's willing to make a deal. When he came upon this young man song on the fiddle and playing it high, and the devil jumped on hickory stumps. So boy, let me tell you what, you might not know it, I'm a fiddle player too. And if you care to make a dare, I'll make a bet with you. You play pretty good fiddle, boy, but give the devil his due. I bet a fiddle of gold against your soul, cause I think I'm better than you. Boy says, my name is Johnny, and it might be a sin. I'll take your bet, you're born great. I'm the best it's ever been. Johnny, rising up your bow and playing her fiddle hard. This hell broke loose in Georgia and the devil deals his cards. And if you win, you get this shiny fiddle made of gold. If you lose, the devil get your soul. Come on, Grace. Opened up his case and said, I'll start the show. And fire flew from his fingertips as he rosined up his bow. Then he pulled that bow across the strings and made an evil hiss. And a band of demons joined in and sound something like this.
voice. Johnny says, you're pretty good, old son. We'll sit right there in that chair. Let me show you how it's done.
Find the mountain, rock boys, run. Devil's in the house, of rising sun. Chicken and bread pan, picking out dough. Branded dog by no child, no. Let's help him out.
Bowed his head, he knew that he'd been beat, and he laid that golden fiddle on the ground at Johnny's feet. And Johnny just says, come back if you ever want to try again, as I told you, won't you, son of a gun. Oh, the best it's ever been.
Find the mountain, run boys, run. Devil's in the house, arise the sun. Shaking the bread pan, picking out dough. Ran in a dog by no child, no. Come on, Brace, take it home.
Once again, thank you guys for spending your evening with us, and we have one last song that we want to play for you, and we've been ending our shows for the last year or two with this song, and I think it's more important now than ever, and I'm not one that really believes in using this platform to talk politics or ideas, but I just want to express how I feel about a couple of things, and The reason why I want to tell you this, because it hits close home for me. Just last year, in Colville, Utah, I buried my grandfather at 94 years old. And at his funeral, or at, I guess at his graveside procession, there was these young men that came dressed up, who came as volunteers. And they handed my mother a flag and said, on behalf of a grateful nation, we want to say thank you. Because my grandfather, when he was 17 years old, was drafted in the United States military, and at 18 he was on a boat headed across the Pacific. 18 and a half and 19, he had landed on 6 beaches, and he buried a lot of his friends on those beaches. But at 94, he could still tell me the serial number that was printed on his rifle. And I tell you this story because I hope it's important and you take time to remember where these freedoms came from. And that there was crazy ideas and crazy things going on in the world before. And there's always going to be good men and good women who stand up and do the right thing. And so when I sing this song, I think of those men and women that made sacrifices so that we can have these discussions today. And we can have them with peace and respect. So I am still proud of where I'm from. I know that it's been sometimes a bumpy road to get here, but we're here. I hope you feel proud enough to sing along with me. If tomorrow all the things were gone I'd work for in my life, and I had to start again, just my children and my wife, I thank my lucky stars to be living here today. 'Cause the flag still stands for freedom, and they can't take that away. Hey. And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the man who died, who gave that right to me. And I'll gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today. 'Cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. From the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston and New York to LA, there's pride in every American heart. It's time we stand and say, hey, that I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the man who died, who gave that right to me. And I'll gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today. 'Cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the man who died, who gave that right to me. And I'll gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today. 'Cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. Thank you guys again, and we hope to see you down the road sometime soon. If you ever see this red bus on the side of the road, just know we're probably broke down. Just stop and say hello. Thank you guys. Have a good evening, everybody. Thank you. I just got reminded, this young lady came up to, we have a really good friend who sings with us every once in a while that is 15 years old. And she is on America's Got Talent right now. Her name's Kennedy Dodds. And if you know Kennedy, you know that she is so dedicated and such a sweetheart. And both of her parents are blind, and they still make it to every gig we ask them to get to. And her two little sisters are suffering from the same degenerative blindness. So it's our opportunity to send somebody who really deserves it onto the finals. Vote for Kennedy Dodds if you get a chance on America's Got Talent. Thank you, guys. Have a good night.